Somehow, music legend Willie Nelson has everyone, young and old, liberal and conservative, singing along. It's true. And at 81, Nelson is remaining relevant. Jan Crawford recently joined Willie Nelson on his tour bus. Lucky you, Jan. Good morning.
Well, good morning. So, you know, I grew up listening to Willie Nelson. My dad was even watching him play song shows in Texas before I was even born. So I gotta say, it's kind of hard to even describe what it was like for me to talk to him. He still spends about half the year on the road, and now he's promoting his newest album, and critics say it's some of his best, most reflective work in years. He has a sound like no other. His voice, one of a kind.
Maybe I didn't hold you.
He's an American original, yet his songs tell stories we've all felt.
But you were always on my mind.
Is that part of your music, that people feel like they can relate?
I think so, and I think that's probably the reason I was put here to write songs and come out here and sing them and play them for people. And people can hear them and relate to what I'm talking about.
At 81 years old, Willie Nelson still is making music that resonates, as we discovered when we joined him on the road.
What keeps driving you?
Music. The music. The energy that we get from playing, and the feedback that we get from people listening to it, that's all good stuff.
His body of work is extraordinary. 21 number one hits and more than 100 albums. His latest, Band of Brothers, reached the top of the country charts in June.
I know you love me 'cause I love you too, but you can't tell me what to do.
He lives life on his terms, with music that somehow puts in words what we wish we could say.
If you had not have fallen, I would not have found you.
There are songs of heartbreak, like my favorite, which Nelson played for me, the classic Angels Flying Too Close to the Ground.
And I knew someday you would fly away.
Of course, it made me cry.
For love's the greatest healer to be found.
He has the image of an outlaw, but friends say he is uncommonly kind, which I saw when I wiped away some tears and lost my contact.
I see it. Yeah, right there.
He found it.
I'm crazy. Crazy for feeling so lonely.
Nelson started on a traditional path in Nashville, but feeling boxed in, he went back to his native Texas. Along the way, the good life became a hard life. He struggled with drugs, alcohol, and marriage. Songwriting was an escape, but with performing came consequences.
Do you feel sad when you're writing them? Like, are you reliving moments in your own life?
Of course, yeah, and when you sing them every night, I think that's why a bunch of us got into drugs and alcohol and things so heavy, is because when you go out there at night and relive all that BS that puts you in that place, and you have to relieve it. Sometimes people can't handle it, and it's too tough.
Roll me in the flame for about an hour.
Nelson says cigarettes were too hard on his lungs, and drinking made him a little crazy. So to take the edge off, he turned to pot.
How much do you smoke pot?
I don't know, as much as I want to. A lot of people couldn't smoke as much as I do. I think I have a pretty good tolerance for it. And it's a good medicine for me. It's a good stress reliever.
He's been arrested at least 4 times for marijuana and is an outspoken advocate for legalization.
Did you ever see a time when pot would be legal?
I never thought during my lifetime that it would, because it was so hardcore against it in so many places, but then it looks like I was wrong.
On the road again.
Nelson says the future looks good for pot, and in the meantime, he plans to keep making music.
In our way,
is on the road again.
But do you still feel like you got something to prove?
I don't think so, unless it's don't stop. You know, don't look back. They might be gaining on you.
That was a nice moment you had with him, Jan.
It was kind of overwhelming.
Yeah. And he's got a wedding ring. That's
Nice. He's been married to number four for several years now.
So. Nice.
Thank you, Jan.
Like, it was great.